All right, we're looking for rituals. Not seeing any. No rituals. This pack's actually pretty bad for us in general. I think we just take a Snapcaster Mage. Should even do what we wanted to do? I think so. I mean, if I don't take that, I'm taking like Sulphur Springs, which is awful. Yeah, I'm just gonna take Snappy. Old Snappies. Time Walk's huge. I'll take Time Walk. Oh, wait, Mach Sapphire. Never mind. Mach Sapphire has to be the choice here. This is, yeah, they definitely stack these packs like this. Time Walk would be huge, especially with Snapcaster Mage, but I think Sapphire is better because we're trying to do everything in one turn in the storm, and this is just a zero mana. I mean, it's just a. The nut, basically. I guess I probably don't have to explain it. I'm just gonna take that. So that's two Mocks in. That's pretty big. What is this two? Oh yeah. So here I kind of want to take a Worn Power Stone. Again, another really good thing with upheaval. Impulse is probably better for the storm deck, but I think we could wheel it. Venser will probably be gone as the blue card, so I'm definitely gonna take Worn Power Stone here. Doesn't do anything the turn we're going off, so certainly worth noting, but. What do we have here? We have a Dark Confidant. Reasonable, but it is significantly scarier when you're playing a limited deck. Because right now, if it like flips these, it's dealing six. Then again, it might just be our pick. I don't want any of these cards. I guess I'm taking it. I could see taking Wildfire as like a sideboard stuff. We have Worn Power Stone, Thran Dynamo, Mox Emerald, Mox Zephyr. Yeah, this is probably better in our sideboard, honestly. I don't think I'm gonna play Bob. Tanglewire strong. What does this card do for us? I don't know. Grab some lands or something. I think I want this against the control decks. Magus of the Moon. Probably just take Flooded Strand here. It can't find anything, so maybe it's not worth it. I don't get any duels. Maybe I just take Chandra. I don't know what she does in our deck. Not a lot, I guess. I guess it's good the turn you're going off, the zero ability. Kind of lame. This do anything in our deck? I'm trying to see. Just doesn't look like it. All right, I'll take a Chandra. I don't know what it does, but ooh, Forcible is pretty big card to have in Storm, but so is Blood Crypt for our deck. We have Marsh Flats to find Blood Crypt. I think I just want the Forcible. How many blue cards? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So not a ton. So it's gonna take it. I think it's correct. We'll see. We'll see if it works out. This pack is awful. I guess I could take an Abyss. It's a reasonable sideboard card. Definitely need the Sulphur Springs here over the ultimate price, I think. I have a Chaos Warp. I have an Agony Warp. I'm not gonna play Aetherling. Orzhov's Signet, I guess I'll play. At this point. I don't have any white cards or anything like that. I mean, I'm not gonna play Living Death. I don't think I'm gonna play this guy. So yeah, I'll just play that for the post upheaval. Don't think this card's doing anything in my deck. I don't think this card's doing anything in my deck, but maybe I just take it. I have Marsh Flats, so I can. Oh yeah, that's what it's Marsh Flats that finds. Marsh Flats can now find an island, so maybe I do want to run that. Sure. Bobby Wield. Not intuition. Impulse to not wield, which sucks for us. Do I play this intuition? I don't know. Don't really know what I'm trying to minus desire and do stuff like that post upheaval a lot of the time here. I have a Wheel of Fortune to help go off. I have some. I think this deck will work. It's going to be an interesting one, though. Nightscape Familiar. I wish I had more rituals. I didn't see any more rituals. And I think if there were any more, I would have gotten them, seeing as Seething Song Wield. That's a decent sideboard card. But, I mean, I do have two Moxes, three Moxes, which are rituals. Nightscape Familiar, who's quite good pre-rituals. The same is said for all these artifact mana. I think I'm just playing all those. Not sure about that. Not sure about that. I don't know if Duress makes it. I think it will. Have Mesmeric Fiend too. I have quite a bit of that effect. I don't think I can play Bob in the main deck. That's 22 cards with a bunch of Moxes. It's not a ton of blue cards is my biggest worry for this Force of Will, but I guess I only need the one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blue cards right now. But the only two I have left are Intuition and Pile and Crown. I guess I could play Intuition. It's not the most unreasonable thing. I don't know what's grabbing most of the time. Probably just three Moxes or something. Chandra is definitely an option here. I think I'm playing. All those five lands. Do I just play Intuition? What am I playing Intuition for most of the time? Thin my deck of lands, I guess. The turn before I go off or something. Not sure. I think I play Duress. Maybe I do just play this. I don't know what I'm using it for, is the big thing. I'm trying to think of what effects I can grab. I can grab Tendrils. Mine's no, because if as soon as Tendrils hits the yard, I lose. I guess not. I have Jace and Ralzarek that could theoretically win. It's nice to have another blue card. Oh, it's decent with Snapcaster Mage. If I grab Snapcaster Mage, Upheaval, Mind's Desire. Don't know if that's anything. I'm trying to make sense out of it. I don't know if that's actually anything, though. Yeah, I just don't know if this card does anything. I really want to give it a shot, just because it's a blue card. Maybe my senses are being, just does not sound good. All right, I'm not going to play it. Decided to not play it. I do want to play one more spell, though. Could just be this Mesmeric Fiend, I guess. He's quite reasonable. Another little disruptive beater. Could also be Chandra. Like, just playing Chandra is, like, pretty reasonable. Like, I have multiple ways to get into play on turn three. Three different ways. Four, five, six, seven. Yeah, maybe I should just play the Chandra. That's also a good card to preempt whatever with. Now, a huge question is, maybe I should play Devil's Play to work with Tendrils? And use all this mana for something and take out, like, either Slaughter Pact or Chaos Warp. Probably Chaos Warp. And play 16 lands with the Lake of the Dead. I'm not even sure about Lake of the Dead, but it seems reasonable. Maybe it's not, though. I don't know how many swamps I'm gonna have. Let me take it out for a second and see. What color? Six blue. I have this. That's it. Oh, and this. That would mean I had three swamps, four swamps to sacrifice the Lake of the Dead. That's not very many. This is plenty of blue. I think I just need another black, and then this is probably fine. These are all blue sources. I guess I have two black sources here. Three, four. Six, seven. That's reasonable. Then I have one, two, three, four, five. Five red sources. So I need to get another mountain in here. Seven, six. That seems reasonable. Chrome Mox can be anything. I am a little bummed about not having a ton for this Force of Will, but I mean, the chances I have an Agony Warp or Daze or something like that in my hand is fairly reasonable. And I have Duress and Thoughtseize in here. I could be playing Intuition over Chandra, but I just don't think it's that good. Could be playing Palancron over both. Actually, should I be playing Palancron? This does let me go infinite with Ancient Tomb, sort of. Should I be playing Palancron? It's a lot of mana to need. It's a free spell if I get to 7 mana or 7 lands. Over Chandra. I don't know if this is an unreasonable thing to be debating. It works pretty well with Nightscape Familiar. Works pretty well with Ancient Tomb. Works really well with Mind's Desire. All right. Chandra, you're getting the boot. Palancron is getting the start. I'm gonna try it. I don't think it's great. I didn't really think about it until this point. But I think it's a blue card for Force of Will. It's a blue card for Chrome Mox. It could be awesome off of a Mind's Desire. It could just be an awesome free spell in the middle of my turn where Chandra can't be. Chandra's more of a setup card. But I have plenty of setup cards. I have all these artifacts and planeswalkers already. So I'm gonna give it a shot. We'll see if it works out. The 16 land Palancron deck. All right, and then let's go to round one.